Hello, I'm John Waters, and I'm supposed to announce there is no smoking in this theater, which I think is one of the most ridiculous things I've ever heard of in my life. How can anyone sit through a length of a film, and especially a European film, and not have a cigarette? But don't you wish you had one right now? And I'm telling you that smoke anyway, it gives ushers jobs, and if people didn't smoke, there would be no employment for the youth of today. So once again, no smoking in this theater.
This is tea. Filling a cup. Not with indigestion. Not with nerves. Not with sleepless nights. This is tea. This is calm stomach. Quiet nerves. Deep sleep. This is tea. Steaming, hot, hearty, delicious, invigorating. The lift that leaves you with a nice, warm glow. So good for you. Make it hefty, hot, and hearty. Take tea and see.
This is art. This is performance. This is theater. You want to know what success looks like? Take a look at the camel-smoking cardinal over there, Lance Weaver, a.k.a. me. Star on the little stage for the past few decades. Impeccable acting chops. Voice of the great Caruso himself. And you know what? I'm an overall great guy. Despite my reputation, I still ride the bike to work just like any other starving artist. Okay, I drive a car, but it's a Volkswagen from the 18th century, so give me a break. I've had a whole lot going on for me my whole life, except for one thing. My fucking heart. The ticker. The fucking thump-thump. I have a disease called aortic stenosis. What it means is, the aorta valve that pumps blood into my heart is too fat and has to work even harder to pump blood, which constantly works up my heart like a Chinese sweatshop. The thing that sucks the most is that the only people who usually wind up with it are old men who are ready to kick it. I was born with this shit. Yeah, I haven't been on death's doorstep or anything, and it's been taken care of very well, but damn, it's annoying. Something always has to be randomly amiss, and they need to go in and take a look. Go in and take a look. Go in and take a look. And once again, tell me that nothing is wrong. Like tomorrow, I had to take the fucking day off and let that pimple-faced weighing kid take my spot while I got a fucking catheterization. Just because some weird shit popped up on my EKG. So they're going to go in and take a look through an artery in my neck. It's going to be a quick one-day thing, and I should be ready for next week's performances. I've had this done a million times before, and I'll probably have it done a million times after, just the same. And I'll be back in time for curtain call. Always.
We'll be right back. Good evening, Mr. Weaver. You can sit down. Don't talk. You can sit down. How you doing? Don't talk. Obviously, we have some important things to talk about, so I'm going to get right to the point. We messed up. Not me in particular, but the surgeons. We've done this procedure 100 times, and you know that, and all smoothly. But I don't know. Have you done any hard drugs? Our records show that you OD'd on opiates in 91. Have you done any opiates in the last 12 months? What about the unprescribed painkillers? Have you done any of that? You have. Don't you know that that could kill you? Luckily for you, that's not the problem. The problem is, you woke up during the procedure. You had a seizure right when the surgeon was making an incision in your neck. Palsy on the table. Rest. That catheter you have in your throat. The surgeon. The surgeon. The rectum. Back and forth. I don't think you understand the situation, Lance.
No, I understand perfectly well. You're a shithead surgeon who fucked up my throat and you're gonna fix it.
We did fix it. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Then get this shit off.
It's not coming off. You're gonna need that for the foreseeable future.
What the fuck do you mean it's not coming off? Can't you just pop me up on the table and replace some shit in there and close me up good as new?
Your throat isn't like an organ that we can transplant, like a heart or a kidney. We just can't order up a new throat for you. It doesn't work like that.
But you don't understand. It has to work. I have a job, a career that depends on my voice, and you're gonna make it work.
I'm sorry. This is just something that we're going to have to deal with.
Come on, Doc.
Mr.
Weaver, tell me something. Give me something.
I'm sorry.
Don't say that.
Mr. Weaver, I know this isn't what you want to hear. This isn't the kind of thing you want to hear, but I'm sorry. I wanted to give you enough time with to absorb this information. I'm sorry, Mr. Weaver.
Doc!
Okay, come on, people. One more time, and this time with feeling.
This thing is supposed to help me talk.
Well, how's it going with that?
It's great.
can't do shit anymore, and I sound like Donald Duck fucked Oscar the Grouch. And listen, I didn't mean to interrupt your rehearsal.
Oh, you're okay.
I'm looking for Royce. Is he here?
I think he is!
Come on, Lance. Come on up to the office.
Thanks, Richard.
All right, people, let's go.
Lance, baby, how you doing? You think you ought to really be doing that with your,
What?
Nothing. Never mind. Hey, I've got this dinner party coming up next Friday night with the David Sellings. He makes the best fucking key lime pie to die for. Why don't you come with? Lance, come on.
Let's quit beating around the bush and just shave it. Who'd you get to replace me?
You want to talk about that now?
You didn't hire that Weyand kid, did you?
No, I didn't hire him. Yeesh. I value my audience's ears.
Then who got the part?
Zion.
Zion? That yutz couldn't do a death scene with the kitchen knife shoved up his ass. Believe me, I know.
Wait, I don't have anybody else. What would you have me do?
What about Eddie? At least he's got chops a bit above a 2.
Eddie is all fucked up in rehab, man.
Fucking idiot.
If I remember correctly, that could have been you.
Piss off. Yeah.
Listen, I don't need this right now. I know a lot of things have happened, a lot of water under the bridge. But we just gotta move on and go forward.
Exactly. That's why I'm here for this month's paycheck.
What?
Last month's paycheck, Royce. Money that I earned and haven't seen a goddamn cent of.
Lance, what are you talking about?
Where the fuck is my money?
I don't owe you any money.
Fuck you mean you don't owe me any money?
I don't owe you any money.
Bullshit! That's a month's salary unpaid, a month's worth of work, Royce. We have a contract.
Lance, sit down.
God, what the fuck is going on?
You're right. We had a contract, but we also had an agreement.
What the hell are you talking about?
We had an agreement, right? We had a fucking agreement. I got your shit in clean and cheap, and for that, I got 40% of your biweekly salary when after your bitch dealer dumped you. You remember that?
No, I don't remember that, actually.
Well, I do, and I remember how many times I had to send Malt out there to pick your ass up out of the street when you're all fucked up on that shit I had to get you.
Hey, fuck you! I don't need you criticizing my lifestyle. I just need my money, asshole.
Listen, I haven't seen any since you started this show. I'm not the asshole here, man. You are.
Jesus Christ. Don't let me get ripped off by this Jew pseudo fag.
What the fuck was that? What does that mean? What does me being Jewish have to do with anything? And pseudo fag? What the fuck are you talking about?
It means you're eating pussy.
You're shitting me.
I saw you with Matt's wife at the season commencement last week. Your hand was a little close to the bottom of her dress, and you're eyeballing that new soprano, too.
You are not serious.
Dead serious, and I bet Mike won't be happy to hear that.
Oh, this is exactly why Jack left you.
You don't know shit.
I know you're a fucking mess, and I'm sick of cleaning up after you.
I'm not asking you to clean up after me. I just want my goddamn salary.
You're not getting it.
Okay. Pseudo fag Jew.
Anti-Semitic bitch!
Royce! Royce!
The thing I ever had a fucking thing for you!
I'm not an anti-Semite!
Your mother sucks cocks in hell, you Nazi bastard!
There's a feeling in the air that you can't get anywhere except in Erie.
I taste a thousand yesterdays, and I love the magic ways of Erie.
From the Great Lakes close at hand,
I can look across the land
and see you touch the sky.
From where the water flows
to where the sunsets go,
we're all good neighbors passing by. Makes no difference
where I go.
You're the best hometown I know.
Hello, Erie.
Hello, Erie.
TV 35 loves you.
You know that's blasphemous, right?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, sure, Lance. I don't know, Lance.
How did you...
Guess they are diluting the sacred wine with some sacred urine these days.
Oh, sorry. My name is Saint Genesius
of Rome.
It's good to meet you.
What kind of name is that? Hippie Donovan or Saintly Crap or something like that?
No, actually it's the regular Saintly Crap. You know, Francis of Assisi, Patrick of Ireland. This is day one stuff, man. Come on.
Am I drunk?
Yes, very. You got Jibber Jabber back there making a great popcorn Sutton. I mean, it's just flawless.
It's the only booze I can get my hands on. My pops counts every drop that he owns. Frickin' wino.
He didn't give you that by chance, did he?
No. Some of the upperclassmen.
You wanna tell me what happened?
Why?
I'm pretty sure I asked you first,
no,
bud.
Whatever. They think I'm a queer.
Of course they think you're queer. You go to an all-boys school, man. It's eventually gonna happen. They think you're a queer. Well, are ya? Hey, you sit back down, all right? It was a joke. Take it easy. Yeesh. Take a chill pill down the hatch, all right? Now you tell me. Why do they think you're a homosexual?
It's stupid.
I mean, of course it's stupid, but you gotta tell me.
I joined mass choir.
That's it? Don't you all have to do that at some point,
yeah,
you know?
In like middle school.
Well, I mean, You guys are all 15. You know, you're gonna get some eventually. Don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. I'm gonna say it a fourth time, don't worry. I mean, you gonna fight him?
No, I can't do that. Hmm. They'd kill me again.
So you're meaning to tell me right here that you are worthless?
No.
Then why can't you stick
I can prove them wrong in other ways.
Bam! That's what I'm talking about, man! You can prove them wrong in other ways. Boom! Bladow! Boom!
How am I gonna do that, huh? Through mass choir.
Mass choir is not necessarily a, you know, winning ticket. Cha-ching! You play any sports?
No. I got a heart condition. I don't do much.
Oh, you got a bad ticker, huh?
I was born with it.
Listen, St. Cecily was blind, but that didn't stop the stones from shouting, Amen! You gotta do something big, all right? Something huge. Something brilliant.
What do you do?
Me? Oh, golly! Jeepers!
I'm so happy you asked me that question.
I only took part in the greatest art form that ever existed. The grand art of Frita.
You're an actor.
Actor? I'm the actor. The actor. The actor!
You look more like a hobo.
Back then! Pretty much the same thing. It was great. Let me tell you, it was great. The money, the women, the acclaim, the recognition, the women.
What did you perform?
Nothing but the greats. Do you know about the greats at all? Little punk kid, you don't know about the greats? Medea, the Odyssey, Oedipus. Emperor Diocletian had a little thing for the Greeks. I don't know about it if you know that. But I was most famous for my biblical satires. I would get up on stage, do a little happy dance, make the people laugh, and kind of mock, make fun of these Christians. Because why not, right?
Thought you were a saint, though. Doesn't sound very holy to me.
Well, we don't just come out blessing people, do we? About to perform for all the Roman people. Now, Emperor D, he's a pretty stand-up guy. As long as he didn't tick him off. And nothing made him more furious than these hippy-dippy radical Christian folk. So I say to myself, Genesius, give him what he wants. Give the people what they want. I'll get a big war out of it, huge applause, a stack of cash for the boot. So I hop up on my stage, right? Follow me, keep it going. And I begin my act.
John the Baptist, I come to you to be baptized in the name of my Father.
Oh. Jesus of Nazareth, I am not worthy to baptize the sandals that you walk in.
Let it be so that I be baptized in my Father's will for all of human righteousness.
And then you know what I did? I mocked the baptism of Christ. And then I saw it. A beam of light piercing the sky. I fell to my knees. And I saw him, his spirit
filling me up inside, and I began to see the error in my ways. I stopped the show, got up, and proclaimed my love for the Christian God. Ti amo, Jesu Christe!
You want to know what they did next?
What?
They cut my head off. And just like that, that's all my canonization was ever worth. A subtraction of a head. I loved what I did, and I tried to do the right thing. But my point is, kid, if you're gonna be an artist, you cannot think about anybody else but yourself. You got that? Not even God.
Okay. What's my first step?
Kid, I can't do everything for you, all right?
But I've never auditioned for anything before. How am I supposed to know what to do?
Kidding me. Bitch, give me a break. God damn it!
We're sorry.
Remember that dancer figurine Ma gave me before she died?
Yeah, what's up?
Did you happen to grab it by accident when you were over here for dinner last week?
No, why?
I can't find it anywhere, Ruby. I thought maybe you grabbed it.
No, I haven't seen it in forever. I think last time was when I helped you move out of Jack's.
Yeah, I took it.
Yeah, no. Wait, you there when we moved.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you said, Jack, keep it.
Yeah, look, I know what I said. Listen, could you swing by Jack's and grab it for me?
Why?
Can you just do it?
No, I'm in Warren at the camp right now. I can't do it right now.
When do you get back?
I don't know. Probably next week. I'm with the girls.
For fuck's sake!
Sorry.
Asshole. Look, I can't pick it up. I haven't spoken to Jack since shit hit the fan way back when. I heard the dick just got out of chemo and he's probably a grouchy little shit. And I don't want him to see me like this.
Like what?
Like with a hole in my throat!
Yeah, sorry about that.
It's fine.
I'm sure it won't be that bad if you two met for coffee sometime about the doll. Time tends to heal most wounds, and you two have a lot of time between the Bothians. Also, I doubt he's too grouchy. Usually people who beat lung cancer are the most optimistic people I know.
Life's a shithole, Lance, in all honesty. A fucking shithole. I'm out mowing my lawn.
Shouldn't you not be doing that?
What, mowing my lawn?
No, smoke.
I'm dying anyways. Might as well put another nail in the coffin.
All right, enjoy your day.
Yeah. Right, fuck it. So anyway, I'm out mowing my lawn, and there's this kid, must be, you know, 16, 17 years old. He's washing his car. He's a shit car, too. I must be trying to make it look nice with a brom or something, I don't know. Anyway, he's washing his car, and the kid's blasting California Girls by the Beach Boys. I couldn't believe my ears. The kid's got taste. So I go over and ask him, what's that you're listening to, just to make sure I haven't lost my mind? And he replies, it's the Beach Boys, but it's probably not your taste. My taste? My taste? What the hell does that mean?
I don't know, Jack.
Who the hell does he think he is?
Listen, Jack.
Beach Boys, not my taste. I invented the Beach Boys. That little da-da-da-da-da-da, the riff on that song. Whole reason I started playing music.
I'm sure the kid didn't.
I don't know if he thinks I'm old or because queers only listen to show tunes and Barry Manilow.
I like Manilow.
Yeah, well, you never did have any taste, did you? What?
Jack.
I'm sorry.
No. It's fine. Do you remember that figurine I had?
What, that antique, the dancer?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's in the basement somewhere.
I was wondering if I could possibly snag it from you sometime soon.
What, like to keep?
Yeah.
No, why would I do that?
Well, considering that it is mine, I would
think wrong. That... It was your mother's. And if I remember correctly, you told me I could shove it.
I know. I want it back now, though.
Well, why do you want it? You're gonna pawn it.
No, I am not.
Fucking pawn it.
Come on.
You're gonna pawn it because, what? You're gonna sell it because you can't pay for your rent, you can't pay for your drugs, what else? I don't know.
Come on, I need this
I'm not gonna let you give it away like that.
I swear to God, Jack.
Gentlemen, you're talking very loudly and you're frightening other customers. If you keep it up, I'm gonna have to ask you to leave.
Sorry. Sorry.
It's okay.
Have you been playing lately?
Playing? Been writing.
Oh shit, a musical?
Christ, no. I'm not that depressed. Nah, just a few pieces here and there. R&H kind of stuff. Days of the Standards are dead. But I'm not. At least not yet.
Was your condition, Ben?
Just say cancer, Lance, huh? Save yourself the embarrassment and be frank with me. Lord knows you always have been. It's been okay. Fight's over for now, they think. Lasted longer than most. Guess being alive is all I can ask for. I got my fingers, my hair's back. I can't get back the lost time.
Stand.
No, you don't. Not yet, at least. But you will. Someday. Maybe you do. I don't know. I was in the pit. We never got the love that you got up on stage. But that's okay. I was in love with the music. Blame Brian Wilson for that. I have so much I still have to say that nobody will hear. So much I still want to play.
Shit. Could go back.
Can't go back, Lance. I'm old.
Old? What does that make me?
Come on, you never cared about bullshitting me to make me feel better. You used to tell it like it was. What up to the cold-hearted honesty you used to go on about? You used to be an asshole about that kind of stuff.
Yeah, well, I'm trying to work on that.
Then don't be an asshole. There's a difference between being honest and being an asshole.
Sorry, I'm still trying to work things out. I just don't know where to go at this point.
This is the part where you explain the,
was an accident. I don't know. Regular procedure. Everything was normal, and I wake up with this. I don't know. And I can't do anything. Jacket's all fucked. Everything. My throat. My life. I was working hard at being the best I could be. I don't understand what's so terrible about that. Life gave me a shitty hand.
Jesus, Lance.
Hey, there is no smoking in here.
Yeah, life's handed you a shitty hand, Lance. You know what you gotta do? Come on. You gotta play a major chord.
Here comes the musical number.
We're all handed shitty hands, Lance. The key is to figure out how to cheat the dealer. A good musician never blames the score for being too difficult. Steady practices, and he gets better.
Cut the musician crap, okay? You sound like an asshole.
You know, back when I was going through chemo, I spent a lot of time in the hospital. Got to know the place, wander around a bit. Got to know a lot of people through my poking around. Turns out, I wasn't the only one who had it bad. In fact, I didn't have it too bad at all. There are some people who showed me what shitty really was. I mean, really messed up. There was this one kid, though. Devin. She had a nervous breakdown in the dressing room before going on stage because she found out her boyfriend had hung himself. The director kept insisting they could call someone in to fill in, but Devin persisted, saying she was okay. When the poor kid went and slit her wrist, you know. She tried drowning them in the sink in the dressing room before going on stage, half naked, bleeding everywhere. The audience was more shocked than she was. She got hospitalized. Now she can't speak in front of four people anymore. Just yells at them in case anybody tries to talk.
Christ.
See what I'm saying, Lance? We aren't the only ones.
We're not freaks like them. It's different.
Oh, come on, piss off. They're as much freaks as you or I. I mean, they can never perform again just like us.
You can still perform. I can't. You can still play.
Yeah, who's gonna hire me, huh? My life expectancy is lower than a house fly's. I'm through.
You have something you love. Why should you be denied that?
Because that's the way things are. You ought to know a little something about that.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing.
The fuck is that supposed to mean?
Nothing, Lance.
Listen, Jack, I'm sorry about what happened between us.
Just forget it, okay?
I'm still trying to figure things out. Why should you be denied the ability to perform just because no one's hiring you? Do your own thing.
Well, who's going to find me a place to perform, huh?
You know what? I will.
What?
Come on.
What the hell's going on in there? What? Talk to me.
Come on.
I'm gonna find you a venue to perform at.
I said no bullshit.
In fact, I'm gonna find a place where anyone could perform. Anyone who has been rejected by the others.
What are you thinking?
I'm sick of the bullshit. I'm sick of the bitching. People like Royce want to fuck us over with their money because we're no longer useful. I'm gonna fuck them right back. Give me the names.
Who?
The people you met.
Which ones?
All of them. The cripples, the vegetables, the dorks, the jugglers, the losers, the Mongolian throat singers, whatever. They can't go to the theater, we'll bring the theater to them. They're probably tired of the pity parties just like us. Well, let's end the party and start the show, starting with you.
Shit, when am I gonna perform?
Those pieces you've been writing.
Those weren't written to be for people to hear.
Come on, this could be great for you.
And you think this is a good idea, working on this together?
Sure. We just won't sleep together. Now the names.
What about you? What are you gonna perform?
I'm not performing.
Why not?
I'm not like them. I had something important, and then it's went away, and it's never coming back. It's different for them.
Well, what's that supposed to mean?
I had something they've been denied for years. Plus, what's the point of me performing? Nobody cares about my shit.
That's baloney.
Come on, let's do this thing. Forget about me. This is your show. I'm just the mastermind. Jack's Follies. Starring the man himself, Jack Craig.
Thank you.
Hello, Mr. Weaver. And what part are you auditioning for?
Pete Travis.
And what piece are you auditioning with today?
I'll be doing a monologue I found at the library from a play called Boot Camp. I'll be doing the song Strike Up the Band by George and Ira Gershwin.
Interesting choice. Do you want to hand me the music? Just bring it over here to the piano.
The role of Pete is more focused on the dancing and the singing and less on the dramatic interpretation. So we're going to focus on the song and dance and kill two birds with one stone. We're going to have our choreographer shout out to you basic instructions for you to perform while you sing. Sound okay?
Okay.
The first thing I need you to do is strip down.
What?
Strip down.
Now we can begin. The results will be put on the front door of the Playhouse at 12 p.m. next Saturday. Have a nice day, Mr. Weaver. Could we have audition number 79 next?
I know who the hell you were. Off nine, care? First time you ever care shit about anything. You're talking to me every night? Huh? You think you can fucking do what you want? Look, I fucked up your audition. Doesn't matter, okay? You hear that clear shit out? Stop!
You fucking touch me, I call the cops!
You what? I hate you!
Thank you.
So you fucked up the audition.
Piss off.
Idiot.
Piss off!
You done fucked up, kid. You done fucked up big time now. It's all right. It's okay. No big deal, sport. You can kind of fix anything if you have the right attitude, as far as I'm concerned. It's all this shit, huh? You just move in or something?
Yeah. Our landlord kicked us out of our apartment. That's why my dad wanted me home early, to help move shit.
What's this?
It was my mother's. She was a dancer. Her dad gave it to her after her first competition in college.
Did she do well?
8th place.
Huh.
Did not know that I'd be playing B.F. Skinner today. Place. Time to bring him the negative reinforcement.
What?
Do you want to fuck up anymore?
Yeah. No.
Hold out your hand.
Why?
Hold out.
What are you doing?
You see that right over there? You want to do better than that, don't you? Hold tight. Hold tight. God damn, hold tight!
Thank you.
Boo! 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 Fucking faggot!
Get out.
Boo! 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 Get off the stage!
Get out!
Unprofessional! Boo! Pathetic! Boo! Lance is pathetic! Boo!
Get out!
Faggot! 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 Boo!
You will destroy my image.
You, my family.
For I. Great man, nonetheless. And I am but one thing. The pursuit.
In return.
Oops, I hear him. A poem to write. A life to live. She may thank me. But I do not give in return.
Get out.
And let me be. Thanks for helping me grow a pair up there.
No problem.
What's your name?
Jack.
Sorry, Jack. They kind of keep us separate, the pit and everything.
It's okay, seriously.
I wonder why that is. The pit people keep away from us?
Well, because actors are usually assholes.
Who says I'm not?
Well, no one, but if you are, at least you're a talented asshole.
Well, Jack, since we haven't met, we had a introduce each other. Maybe like one of those drama icebreakers. I'm Lance Weaver. My favorite color's red. Now you go.
I'm Jack Craig, and I don't think you're very funny.
Sorry.
It's okay, don't apologize. I guess I'm not that funny either. Oh, no, don't smoke.
What a great idea. You know what I find funny?
Huh.
Upstairs, you were all Mr. Rogers with trying to talk to me to get me to come down to the stage. But I heard that you had doubts in me since we started rehearsal.
What? I never said that.
Not what I heard.
What? From who?
Everyone.
Well, I still say the greatness is more in the material than the performance.
Still say? When did you say that before?
Just now.
You're worse than me. We should go on a date sometime. Maybe get some dinner or...
Wait, what?
Oh, shit. I'm sorry, I thought that you were a...
No,
that's
yeah,
what
that's,
I heard.
That's true, it's just... You don't just demand shit like that.
I didn't demand anything.
Yes, you did.
Will you go on a date with me?
I don't know.
Why not?
I don't know if I care about you, let alone like you enough to go on a date with you.
Well, that's why I want to go on a date with you. I don't know.
I'm sorry.
Look, no, it's okay. Listen, tomorrow, before the show, not after, okay?
Where?
Satellite Coffee.
Okay, okay.
Okay.
Satellite Coffee, 4:30 before call.
Okay. See you there.
Wait! Can I have your number?
Nope.
Let's get this rehearsal on the road. Variety show rehearsal number one. Here we go.
You don't have to use that, you know.
All right. It's great to see that you were all able to make it here today, and you even brought some friends. I think we're going to be doing some great things in the next month or two. What do you think? Okay. So before we start, though, I think some introductions are in order. My name is Jack Craig. I am a pianist and a songwriter, and I've been doing work in the pit at the Playhouse for about 100 years, or something like that. I will be performing some songs that I've written, and I will also accompany anyone who needs music played, but we will get to that. This is Lance over here.
Lance Weaver. I used to be an actor till I got fucked over by my body, my ego, and a team of surgeons. Anyway, I'm assistant directing the show. Well, really just organizing things and getting a venue, and yeah, it'll be good. Yeah.
Lance will also be performing a piece that will wrap up the show.
No, I will not.
Well, I am working on that. So, why don't we go and see what you guys want to perform, okay? Shall we?
Yeah!
Anybody want to go first? All right, well then why don't we start with you with the guitar. All right, what's your name, son?
Alex.
All right, why don't you tell us what you'll be performing for us, Alex?
Do I have to say?
It's okay, that's what you're here for.
Okay, we'll get back to you, right, Jack? How about you, Mickey Mouse, up front?
Me?
Yeah, what's your name?
That's
Devin. My name's Devin.
Devin, how do you do? I'm Lance. What will you be performing?
Waiting for Godot.
A duo piece. Who's your partner?
No one. I'm doing the whole thing by myself.
Huh. Which scene? And by the way, you don't
need
to...
I'm doing the whole thing.
Which scene, smartass?
What do you mean?
You're not doing the entire fucking script, are you?
Why not?
Why not? Are you out of your mind?
What are you saying?
What I'm saying is you can't do an entire full-length play at a variety show.
Why not?
Jack, this kid is a joke.
But I can't do that. You're gonna tell me what to do, prick?
Hey, you need to calm down. I'm gonna put you in timeout. Relax.
What did you say to me?
Nothing. I'm just busting your balls. Go on, do your thing.
Yeah, fuck you! You're just a burnt out piece of shit with a fucking packing peanut as a blowhole. I'm not gonna take crap from this fucking shithead.
Should have just let it be.
Does anyone want to perform their piece? All right, buddy, come on up.
My name is Charles.
All right, Charles, what will you be doing for us today?
I'm gonna be singing a song from Oklahoma.
Classic. All right, let's hear it.
I'm about to get you a sheet music here.
Oh, shit, my bad. I got you covered.
got to warm up. Can you hit that note again?
Excuse me for a moment. Keep at it, Charles.
Five. What's going on?
I can't do this, Jack.
What are you talking about? This was your idea.
I know, but it's not gonna happen. It's a mess, a fucking mess.
Come on, it's gonna work out.
Fucking easy for you to say.
Hey! Look, you're just nervous, that's all. This is the way all shows start out.
This is not a normal show, Jack. I don't know why I'm wasting my time with this shit. I'm broke. I'm lucky I found a job. I mean, they're paying me cheap, because no one else would hire me, but at least they're paying me. What's this getting me? An ulcer.
It'll work out. We just have to stick it out. Come on. Fuck us, right?
We just have to stick it out for a while, huh?
It'll go by quickly. Trust me. Once you get these people on stage, it's gonna fix itself. Which reminds me, I need you to go talk to this theater owner about using his venue.
What, you found a place?
Yeah, good one too, on Upper State. And here's the big part, we're getting it scot-free.
What? Not only did you find a place, but for free?
Guy's a performer himself, just wants to be in the show.
He wants to be in our show? Who would want to be in our show?
Yeah, he's probably got a terrible voice or something, but couldn't hurt. So, I need you to go check out the place tomorrow.
Oh, come on, Jack, I gotta work tomorrow. Can't you do it?
You've gotta do something, Lance.
Was it thinking up this nightmare enough?
Nope. Richard O'Brien, don't just dream it, be it.
Can I give you a hand with that?
No, I got it. Thanks.
You must be Lance?
Yeah.
Hi, Lance. I'm Joe.
Jack's been talking a lot about you. We really appreciate everything.
Jack's a good guy. I don't mind helping at all. He's been real good to me lately. Especially with the way business has been.
Yeah.
This might be just what this place needs.
Yeah, sure.
I know it's a bit of a mess right now, but we can get it cleaned up before the show, right?
Yeah, right. So, when was the last time there was a performance in here?
Oh, it's been 5 or 6 months.
Yeah, what was it?
It was a rock show with bands, they like hardcore punk stuff. The kids were jumping over the pews, having a good time. It was great.
How many people can we seat in here?
We fit 50 or more people in here easy.
50, huh?
Yeah, no problem. What kind of thing you got going? How long do you think your show's gonna go?
Oh, I think it'll go about 2 hours or so. We got 12, 15 acts, give or take.
Okay. And Jack said that I could be one of those acts. Can I still participate? Is that cool with you?
I suppose you're gonna dance for us. Never mind. What are you gonna do?
I made a movie and finished it up last month. I was thinking about screening it at your show.
That's interesting. What's it called?
It's called Attack of the Punk Eaters.
Oh.
I got a bunch of the local punk rock kids playing music in it for me.
Shit!
You got a problem?
Fuck! I'm late for work. I'm really sorry, Joe. I gotta go.
Can I give you a ride? I got my car downstairs.
No, I'm fine. I'm fine.
You sure?
Yeah. I'll be back tomorrow to talk about more logistics of the show. I gotta go. I really gotta go. I'm sorry.
No problem. Sorry about that.
come on! Fuck!
Going, Lance.
I'm so sorry. I'll get right to work.
No, you won't. Lance, you're fired.
I'll give all my tips in the house. It'll be okay.
Lance?
Come on, seriously, it'll be okay. Just let me work.
You're fired.
Come on. I'm putting on a show for a good cause, so I'm a little bit late. I'm sorry, but I'm not lazy. I need this job.
You've said that before. Okay, and the time before that. Look, I like you, all right? And I respect you as a person, and your priorities outside of work, but I have a restaurant to run, and I need reliable workers.
I understand that, Roger. That's why I'm gonna go right in there and get right to work.
No! You're done. You're fired.
Come on!
Just have to sing it.
Why?
Because the composer put it in there, dumbass.
It's filler.
I don't care. Sing the damn song. Listen, I don't like it either, but if it's in the score, it's in the score. Just suck it up and sing it.
It's gonna fuck up my reputation.
Why? For doing exactly what you're told? That's exactly what these director hacks are looking for. You gotta stop caring so much about what other people think of you.
My sis keeps telling me that.
Well, because she's smart.
And I'm not. All right, let's just do the damn piece.
No, let's not just do it, okay? You're an actor, you gotta put in the work.
And you're the piano player, and you play the piano.
Look, I'm being serious. What inspires you? Why are you singing this?
Because the composer put it in the score the last minute.
Lance.
What? You Elia Kazan now or something?
What inspires you?
I don't know.
Well, that's what this piece is about. Think.
I don't know. There was or is this dancer.
A dancer?
Not a real dancer. A figurine dancer. A porcelain figurine my mother gave me before she died. She used to be a dancer, wanted to be at least. She trained for years and might have made it, I don't know. But she loved him more than anything. In college, she entered a competition and in some miracle, made it in. Everyone else was from conservatories and shit. She couldn't afford art school. She prepares for months, builds up her bones, could have taken down Joe Green. And then the competition comes up. She got 8th place. 8th place. She always told me that. And this is the part that never made sense. She didn't care. She was so proud of herself, and so was her father, that he went out and got this porcelain figurine. So proud. She continued to dance and never did anything professionally beyond that. I guess she just did it for pleasure. I never got that.
Got what?
Oh, she could be okay with getting 8th place. How it doesn't matter, especially since she loved it so much. I would have quit knowing that's all I was to everyone. 8th place? I don't know. She just did it because she wanted to.
Isn't that all any of us do?
It's not that easy, at least for me. Everyone just seems so fake. Everyone just seems to coast along through this like it's not a big deal.
Let's be in a show and get margaritas afterwards!
This means something more to me. Nothing else matters.
Just be careful, Lance.
What do you mean?
Just be careful, okay? Here, let's finish this piece, okay? Take it from bar 8.
Okay.
All right, let's hear it!
Show with that, I think. Okay, now that we've added a film piece from the theater owner, Joe, I think we should round out the show with one more piece, a dramatic reading of some sort.
Who's gonna do it, you?
No. Someone with experience, someone who really knows his craft, someone who's been doing this for years. And you know what? Everything I just said reminds me of someone in this room right now. Lance Weaver.
No.
Lance, you put this thing together. You have to be a part of it.
No! I don't have anything prepared. I can't.
Yes, you can.
No one wants to hear me perform, right, Devin?
Eat shit.
See?
All right. Seriously? Besides, this isn't about what the people want. This is about what you want. That's why you did this thing. For me, for these people, and I think for yourself. You've got all these people who haven't had confidence in years to believe in themselves again. And I think the person responsible for that should as well. All right, if not for you, then do it for me.
do it. Eat shit and die, right?
Close enough. Great. All right, so what are you going to be doing?
I have absolutely no idea.
It's okay. Just have something ready for final dress, all right?
Yes, boss.
Look at him. He's a smartass.
Hey, Jack. Can we go home? It's 8:30.
Oh, shit. I'm sorry, guys. Listen, go home and get some rest. And don't forget, we're in the theater tomorrow, Upper State. And don't use the elevator. It stinks.
Auditioning for the Gershwin show? I thought you weren't going to do that.
Then why wouldn't I do that?
Well, I thought... You're supposed to be focusing on fixing yourself up.
I'm fine.
You're not a doctor, honey. I think Dr. Z knows a little bit more than you do. He did restart your heart after all.
I'm just smoking a J. I'm not shooting up. Fine.
I think you need to step back and take a look at yourself. It's gonna take more than some coffee and cigarettes to get this garbage through your system. I don't think doing another show right now is the best idea.
So, you have a better idea of what I should be doing with myself. And what's that?
That's not what I'm... Stop it. That's not fair.
No, I want to know what you think I should be doing with myself.
I don't know. Take some time out of the spotlight. Spend time with me. Go out a little.
So this is about you then?
What?
You want me to stop performing so much so you can see me more. That is so fucking selfish.
That's not what I'm saying.
Give a shit about anything I do? If I'm not performing for people, there's nothing, okay? The only thing I care about is those people clapping as I leave the stage. Then my job is done. And I'm not letting you or a doc take that away from me.
I'm not saying to give up. I'm just saying take a break.
Listen, I know you've been a bit down and out without getting enough work, but I am not. So don't try to put me in the same position you are, Jack.
Lance, that's not what I'm trying to do. I'm just saying, think about yourself and us above your reputation for one moment.
Okay. Bye.
What are you doing?
Just like you suggested, I'm going out.
Where?
Out!
when you're smiling, when you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you. When you're laughing, when you're laughing, the sun comes shining through. But when you're crying, you bring on the rain. So stop your sighing, be happy again. Keep on smiling, 'cause when you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you.
Can I go on?
When you're smiling.
Hello?
When you're smiling.
Are you kidding me?
The whole world smiles with you.
I've been waiting for an hour and a half to do
when
my
you're
piece.
Laughing,
Evan, there's someone performing now.
When
you can go
laughing,
on when he's finished.
Bullshit, Jack. You said that 45 minutes ago.
Devin.
You know what? Let it go. You want to do your bit, Devin? Go do it.
All right, let's get Gramps off the stage.
Nope, he's not done. He gets off the stage when he's done. You want to do your piece? Go do it.
All right.
Be happy again. Keep on smiling.
Given the existence, as uttered forth in the public works of Puncher and Robin, of a personal god, quack, 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 quack,
damn it, Devin!
With white beard, quack, 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 quack,
quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack,
quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack,
you didn't let me finish.
No, I didn't, Devin.
Fuck!
Devin, there's other...
Devin!
Stop it! You can't do shit like that, Devin. You can't. I know you've been through a lot, but you've got to pull yourself together. You're freaking me out. You're here. You're good enough. You don't need to keep doing shit to piss me off just to get my attention. I stopped you because you were being an asshole. Not because you sucked.
What do you mean?
Fred was... is still singing. I want it to be over, too. The stage is his. Not yours, not mine, his.
But when you're
crying, I didn't think you would do it. Jesus! Come on. We'll go through your piece tomorrow before the show. I won't stop you. I'll give you notes. Okay?
When you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you.
Very good job, Fred. Really powerful.
Right. Thank you. Let's wrap it up. I think that's everything, Jack.
Lance, we're going to need you to do your monologue.
Why?
Because we need to know what everyone's doing. We open tomorrow.
I told you, I'm just gonna make something up.
You're gonna need to do it now, Lance.
But why?
Because that's the way things are run. Everyone else has done their bit. We need to know what you're doing so that when you set the stage on fire, everybody knows what's going on.
I told you, I'm just gonna make something up.
Doesn't matter. It's a courtesy to your fellow performers.
Thank you.
I think that's about it for today, everybody. Don't forget, dress rehearsal tomorrow morning. Oh, and good job, everyone. Lance.
You can't do it.
It's fine.
You can't do it, Jack.
Okay. Lance, I got Chinese to celebrate. Getting cold.
Shit. Just a minute, okay? Hey.
What the hell are you doing?
Huh?
Look at yourself.
Come in.
What's going on?
What?
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 We have a performance tomorrow. What the hell is this?
Trust me. This is nothing. I'm gonna need a lot more than this to get through tomorrow.
You can't do that.
I can do whatever I want. And right now, I want to pass the fuck out.
You put so much work into... Why are you upset?
I'm not upset. I'm just done. Done. Done, done, done.
This is important.
It's garbage, Jack. It's fucking garbage.
No, it's not.
You have no clue, sweetheart. You have no clue what a... waste this is.
You know what? You're one to talk.
You're right. I'm shit, too. I can't even talk without wanting to gouge my throat out. Congrats. You're right about me. I'm a fuck-up. Hooray! Be lucky if we get three people to show.
It's not about the audience, it's about you.
Bullshit. Bullshit! It's always about the audience. The difference between Laurence Olivier and community theater is the audience. You can give the best performance of your life, but if no one shows up, you're shit. Simple, simple, simple.
That's not true.
That's true to you, because you've been coasting on your mediocrity your entire life. Decades spent in that same crummy pit job. You could get out of here, but no, you don't do shit for yourself. And you have the balls to feel sorry for me? I feel bad for you.
Really? Because last I remember is you coming to me at the cafe with your fucking sob story. 20 years, no talking. I understand. I let it be. I don't hold grudges.
Shut the hell up! You despised me because I came in at 28 and kicked everyone's ass. You were jealous because I got all the good roles right off the bat and you were fucked over in that pit year after year. You wanted that shit. Write your own show, yada, yada, yada. You needed the applause. You loved me because you wanted to be me. You fucked me because you wanted a piece of something you couldn't have.
You have no clue how I felt about you then.
You never cared. And now you're gonna force me out on that stage just to embarrass me.
That has nothing to do with anything. I have another partner now. I've been with him for 6 years. I don't hold any grudges against you because I thought we were done with this. I thought we were through with this shit.
Bullshit show. Who does this help? Me?
Yes. This is about you. This is not about me or us or the audience.
Now you're gonna tell me you don't care about the audience. It's all about you. How it makes you feel. What you get out of it. Well, I take a look at you and I figure that you philosophy doesn't really get you anywhere. So why don't you be a good boy, have a drink, and shut your goddamn mouth.
This is fucking bullshit, Jack! You're just gonna throw me out on the street with a bag full of nothing?
This is my house, Lance, and I want you out now! Your sister can come pick up your shit later this week. I don't want you around here anymore!
For Christ's sake!
For Christ's sake, nothing! You did this!
I did this? We got the fucking drunk police over here trying to protect me from the weed, man!
Shut up! Just... I can't keep taking care of you, Lance. You cut yourself up. You carve up others. And you don't care what you don't return. Maybe you don't love yourself anymore, but I do. And I can't keep taking care of you if you keep doing this. This will kill you. And I don't want to be around to see it. I can't be. Can I do anything for you? Help pack anything?
No. You can just take it, shove it up your ass, and choke on it!
Have reached the voicemail box of
Lance Weaver.
Hey Lance, it's Devin from the show. I thought we were supposed to practice my monologues before the show. Come on man, pick up the phone. It's 1 o'clock man, did you forget the call or something? Whatever. You can go fuck yourself. Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Jack Craig's Follies.
Let the drums roll out, let the trumpet call, while the people shout, strike up the band. Hear the cymbals ring, calling one and all to the martial swing. Strike up the band. There is work to be done, there's a war to be won, come you son of a gun, take your stand, find ye a foe, come along, let's go.
Thank you, Madeline. You know, it's been so crazy here this afternoon, I'm surprised I haven't fallen off my own feet. Well, I guess with all the other acts done, that just leaves me. But first, let me say thank you to everyone who has come out here this afternoon. It means so much to me and to everyone else that was on this stage here today. I've been doing this for a lot of years, for sold-out shows and small venues alike, but this one really takes the cake. Okay, without further delay, this is a little tune I've written entitled, How Do You Tell a Man?
What are you doing here?
Just wanted to check in with the talent post-performance.
Fuck you.
Calm down. Relax. It's fine.
It's okay. She's right. I fucked up. Sorry. I had a little too much last night, and I overslept.
It's 3:00.
Yeah, fuck me, right? I messed up. I'm sorry. You were right. I bet you were fantastic. How'd you do?
Well, I did it, that's for sure. Got through the whole thing this time.
Good to hear. Charles, how'd you do?
I had fun.
Good.
Thanks.
No problem. You worked for it.
No, I mean for this.
What?
For doing this show.
Don't worry about it.
I mean it. I know you're a fuck up.
Thanks.
But you did something different. You gave us something no one ever would or could have.
What?
You gave us your heart. You gave us your heart and a stage to perform on. I don't know. Thanks. You mean a lot to these people.
Don't say that.
Why not?
Because I'm far from that.
Not from where I stand.
Hey, well, your view must be blocked from there. Charles, go tell Jack I'm gonna go on.
What?
Just go do it.
Very interesting fellow. I don't know what he's doing here, but since this was his idea, I guess I'll humor him. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present our last act, Mr. Lance Weaver.
Thank you.
Dunzo, dongo, doing. Pussy in the floor, old man.
Out.
You can't do this anymore. Out. Get the
Get
fuck
out.
Get out, you demons of my soul, and rid my mind of evil cacophony and malice. For I am the master of myself, not you. You shall destroy my image, persecute my family, rob me of my fortune, but you will not rape my dignity, for I am a man. Again, I am a man. A man of great misfortune, but a man nonetheless. And as a man, I am entitled to but one thing, my own pursuit of happiness, and no one shall claim ownership of what is mine. You can spit on my name, drag me into the streets, rip out my throat, give me a mechanical heart, it will not matter to me. I will survive. I will persevere as have the greats before me, and will continue to do so until the axis stops spinning. Get out and stop holding the strings of my limbs and my dignity, controlling my mind and where it wanders and what it believes. You are not the answer. I am the answer. I may not be the answer for you, but I am the answer for myself. I do what I do because I have loved and continue to love. Not to demand the love of those that control my insecurities. I will not be a slave to the beliefs and opinions of others. Selfish you may call me, but I do not give love and demand it back. Life is simple. We live, we die. When we die, the only thing we can take with us is our memories. What are my memories? Doubt. Hatred. Nothing. How I long for the day where my thoughts were not controlled by others. I am but a simple man. All I want is a song to sing, a poem to write, a life to live. Get out, for I am a man.
Thanks for running back to the place and getting me this last minute.
No problem.
Was I okay?
You were great.
It's okay. Why don't you go on ahead? I'll catch up with you. And close the windows, for Christ's sake. Wasting the AC. Let's walk. Owner doesn't like it when you smoke out front.
Clogs the sidewalk.
Well, I don't nerve going back there.
I know that.
Just shut up, okay? Let me talk, Karen. I've got not a lot to live for, you know? Ben, maybe you've met him, but not much beyond that. Lance, what happened all those years ago doesn't mean much to me anymore. But that didn't mean that you didn't. When I kicked you out, it wasn't because I hated you. I never hated you. I kicked you out because I wasn't allowed to be happy with you anymore. Because you wouldn't let yourself be. I convinced myself I hated you because I stopped thinking about romance with you. Then I realized that reading something that much...
I never hated you. I'm really sorry.
I forgave you years ago. You calling me up to meet you for pancakes was the only apology I needed. Let me finish though, okay? I learned that hating was worth a damn. I learned that I still thought of you as a friend somehow. I don't know, you spend so much time being so close to someone, even if the romance is gone, you can't pretend that you didn't give yourself a piece of yourself to play along with you. Hating was simply exhausting. I wanted to do this show with you to stop seeing you hate so much.
I don't hate.
I wanted to see you stop hating yourself. You know, you've hated yourself so much that you've only been able to... You've only seen yourself through others' eyes. That's what the show is. Shit's gonna kill me. We got a few years left. A terrible patient, can I say. And don't tell my doctor about this shit because my insurance rate will skyrocket. But who cares though? I'm happy. You gave one hell of a monologue back there. How do you feel?
Jack, please let me say I'm
sorry.
Don't
apologize. Just answer the damn question. Christ, you're annoying. Move on.
I felt good. I never felt that way before, honestly. I want to do it again.
What?
Different acts, different things.
We barely paid the AC for this one.
Fuck. I want to keep doing this. For these people and for us. This town is not that small. Voice can't fuck over everyone like us.
Like you. I retired by choice, remember?
Yeah, fuck you, Liberace.
Liberace. That'd be nice.
It can only get better from here. 3 or 4 people today, 10 in a month, 100 a year from now. I think we should do it. Come on.
We'll make it work somehow. Listen, I gotta get back to my place. I'm sure Ben's left the window open or something. Love him to death. I got something for you, though.
What's that, a hoagie?
Yeah, with all the coleslaw in it. Just like Pittsburgh. Don't be smart. It might change my mind.
Thanks.
No problem.
Hey, let's grab lunch sometime at Calamari's or something.
All right, you pay.
Hey, I'm dying here.
So am I.
Stop. It's like when you go to read your own poetry, you get all choked up.
And I'll tell a story about an artist growing old. Some would try for fame and glory, others aren't so bold. Everyone and friends and family saying, hey, get a job. Why do you only do that only? Why are you so odd? We don't really like what you do. We don't think anyone ever will. It's a problem that you have, and this problem's made you ill. Listen up and I'll tell a story about an artist growing old. Some would try for fame and glory, others aren't so bold. The artist walks alone. Someone says behind his back, he's got his gall to call himself that. He doesn't even know where he's at. The artist walks among the flowers, appreciating the sun. He does this all his waking hours. But is it really so wrong? They sit in front of their TVs, saying, hey, this is fun. And they laugh at the artist, saying he doesn't know how to have fun. The best things in life are truly free. Singing birds and laughing bees. You got me wrong, says he. The sun don't shine in your TV. Listen up and I'll tell a story about an artist growing old. Some would try for fame and glory, others aren't so bold. Everyone and friends and family saying, hey, get a job. Why do you only do that only? Why are you so odd? We don't really like what you do. We don't think anyone ever will. It's a problem that you have, and this problem's made you ill. Listen up and I'll tell a story about an artist growing old. Some would try for fame and glory, others just like to watch the world. Up and I'll tell a story
about an artist growing old. Some would try for fame and glory, others aren't so bold. Everyone and friends and family saying, hey, get a job. Why do you only do that only? Why are you so odd? We don't really like what you do. We don't think anyone ever will. It's a problem that you have, and this problem's made you ill. Listen up and I'll tell a story about an artist growing old. Some would try for fame and glory, others just like to watch the world.